that he's just never going to go past the Relic Shield, because probably. I think it's going to take a long time to actually get to the 500 gold for the Sight Stone upgrade if you're not consistently executing minions. Very likely just wants a very heavy sustained lane, and here is Radover going for the early dragon. It is the Infernal, and both junglers looking to do what they do best. Nardox looking for a gank.
Body slam flash from Fog of War. He could have done anything, and First Blood comes through to feed. Looks like just the lane pressure of Braum himself has meant that Agent had to play back, and it's been the CLG push the whole time. 2-on-2 in the mid lane as Phoenix walks right in to a Nunu channeling, but the stop one prevents it all. Absolutely zero damage dealt. Yeah, ult means nothing, another kill. Mid lane, top lane, in a reasonable spot for the CLG squad, so we'll see when they actually choose to pull the trigger. Cloud Drake up in 15, big damage out of Darshan at the top side, and Huni is flashless. One more clock will kill him, and he does it. Darshan solo kill in the top lane.
The tracker's knife, he clears out a couple pink wards. He can look to threaten this dragon take. I do like the fact that he is down here applying this pressure. We'll see if he's actually willing to start it up, though, as there is a lot of Echo Fox members in the area.
They know the leashing, and they can see Ryze start casting spells over the wall, so how much damage can he get? Lands the sleep. This can be some good damage. Mike goes over to Darduk, actually. The hook's gonna come back now at a Nunu. The front line is here. Rumble attacks on a three, and here comes a fight as Optics nearby. Knocks them backwards, gets them out of range. Another Drowsy and then a Gragas. They're gonna body block this, though. Go forward, yep. Half HP on Adrian, but
this pressure up, because the mid game and the late game is really where they have struggled. They have had some pretty solid early games throughout the season, so we'll see where they go from here.
We'll see what comes up from this one. Once again, we look at ourselves in the top lane. 15 CS difference. Darshan in the lead gets a nice ulti across, but back to Midianar means he might have to run away from this trade, as Huni gonna land a lot of these attacks right now. Gets the passive coming in as well. Darduk nearby. Flash is up for Darshan, but his health bar getting a bit low. Flash is early. Darduk gonna flash ult. He's gonna land the first little bit as slow as well, and there's the shot in. Huni gets himself a kill. Revenge with the help from Darduk.
Nicely done there from Darduk.
What comes up from this one? Once again, we look at ourselves in the top lane. 15 CS difference. Darshan in the lead. Gets a nice ulti across, but back to Midianar means he might have to run away from this trade, as Huni gonna land a lot of these attacks right now. Gets the passive coming in as well. Darduk nearby. Flash is up for Darshan, but his health bar getting a bit low. Flash is early. Darduk gonna flash ult. He's gonna land the first little bit as slow as well, and there's the shot in. Sure, and you talk about giving up ground. I mean, take a look if we could talk of the vision on Echo Fox's control of that western jungle right now. Several deep wards actually inside of CLG's blue buff area.
Darshan looking.
For Baron, looking now for Adrian. The flash will be knocked right back and kicked out by Altec for the re-engage. Drowsy, this could be the kill. Do they land the skill shots? He's gonna wake up and stick safe. Finds himself a kill, 2-3 on the scoreboard now. 4v5. Does Huni choose to join? Yes, Baron not gonna land though, so now support missing, 5v4 for CLG.
Well, the question is, do they start up the Baron? Do they actually feel like they A, have to, or B, can Huni getting chunked a bit there? But Darshan is gonna go back to base. He has his TP available. And it's Echo Fox shoving mid, trying to get priority.
Pretty good job by CLG finding the opening picks. Those bubbles, sleepy troubles been happening. And yes, and we're going to go ahead and knock down some more wards, CLG. So they are starting to rest control back over. They've gotten rid of most of those Echo Fox wards around this river.
But it's Phoenix on the bot side. And I think CLG, they're going to go for Huni here.
Not a lot of ways out. He's got Flash, burns it, but he's going to get hit by the absolute zero. The damage up pretty high. The rest of the chain's going to be there. He's just buying seconds as the bot lane tier 2 falls. The chill comes over. The turret for a kill. Generally going to favor Echo Fox, though.
CLG has to start Baron, though. Now they have one man down. TP is not going to be available for Huni. Phoenix is on the bot side. At least force out the TP here from Phoenix. Make him respawn, but Darshan is good, looking to go Mega.
He got knocked in by Gragas and kicked right back out by Altec, so no engage we had for him.
Again, spears are stacking.
Yes, they are. They're going to turn back to the fight. Darduk comes in. They hook in. Gets saved right back out as Braum looks at the re-engage. Knocking him on the knock-up, though. Darduk in the middle of five, though. There's the stun. Is the damage going to stick on through? Body slams away. Meganar into the wall. Gets himself one kill. And Adrian out of one third as well. The second kill going to come through, no problem. Altec and Phoenix could not possibly win this fight anymore. And Altec not going to join him in the... Oh, he didn't actually...
Oh, he mistimed it.
The timing was wrong, and he fell asleep for something. So no escape tools there. Missed the skill shot, get the kill anyway, just Zoe things, and Phoenix certainly going to die. He is drowsy, he is going to fall. The Zonias to keep him safe. Misplays it, actually, and one kill comes through. Ryze doing nicely, the shutdown comes in. What a chaos.
Call them back to this Baron and either start it up or threaten to do so, and I think they're going to go right on it.
All right, knock it down the wards, and here comes the next attempt. Double control just to make sure they can see all of it. And good luck getting rid of this Baron. Darduk is flashless, and he's not... Okay, now he's in range for the attempt.
Ryze is so far away, though. Need to commit.
Barrel chain lands on the back line. Huhi and Balfour's and a half. Random getting really low. Actually, down to 1k. 2800 head. There's the smite, and they grab the Baron. No problem there. Meganar in there. No ulti available for a few more seconds. He's going to get knocked around a little bit. Absolute zero to D zone the team. And back in goes the team. Hook's gonna miss the wide and stick slay by himself, but he's got life. But I think most people can know two is greater than one, so looks like a better trade for CounterLogic Gaming. Over the wall they go, getting rid of the blast plant. Baron in 30
Phoenix
seconds.
Maybe caught out.
Ooh, Zoe gone already though. Phoenix caught out Huhi on this one, but he's very much alone. Not a lot of escapes left for him, and the damage going to come through. So both of you missing a mid laner now. Who wins the 4-on-4?
Darshan isn't here, though.
They want this one without Darshan. 4.3 is a good call. They're going to find the third kill this fight as Balfrost does not have an escape available. Dardok gets himself the killing blow. 3-for-1. Get the mid lane farm. Plus 2 kills, plus a Baron, minus 2 turrets. I would take Echo Fox for that.
By far. And they're going to be able to have the Baron buff working for their favor to help them get positioning around the Elder Dragon, which is now live here as well. Definitely a run.
Due to who he's attempts.
And both teams have big waves in the side working for them. Echo Fox, their bot lane wave is looking very good. CLG has a big wave stacked up on the top side, but Echo Fox also pushed in mid lane. Stixxay is going to have to go to respond to that. Who he had to go back to base because he was poked out. He's actually TPing very far away from this.
This seems like an unfightable Drake battle, then maybe Rainover can go for a consume spine. That might be the only trade. Otherwise, there's not a lot of ways to fight for this one. So he's coming back in.
Darshan is almost mega.
And he's close to mega, absolutely the right thing. And oh, the kill on a Darshan. The jungler is gone to the front line. They pulled
back.
Darshan! Oh, nice kickback though, but still 2 kills already. The third gonna come through with the Rand. The chase is in! He's looking for number 4, Stixxay. Just like in the finals so long ago. Looking for the chase down, then the Phoenix flashes over the wall. Q's not gonna land. Then here comes Darshan with the ult into the wall. Who he gets himself the fourth of the fight. As Stixxay, life stealing up. The Drowsy is in. The A's completely 5-for-0 to CounterLogic Gaming. It'd be 15 seconds to 25 on the shortest response, but 40 for the carries. The first turret is down. Next up is the Inhibitor. And it's just that quick race, but it should be enough DLG. The first turret under fire. Do you believe it? It's CounterLogic Gaming when all hope was lost to give the first defeat of the season to Echo Fox. They improved the 2 and 3. The defense not going to be here in time. CounterLogic Gaming, true to the name.
And what a final team fight there for CLG. It seemed like they had been out-CL'd. It seemed like Echo Fox had held on long enough. Echo Fox gets the Baron.